Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and on the test bench today we have the John Mayer signature Paul Reed Smith J-MOD amplifier. Re-released for 2018, this is a strictly limited and exceptionally high-end amp from the good folks at PRS, and it is a beautifully open, expressive and toneful beast with a price tag to match. I'll let you look that up yourself. Now, it's a single channel design with a switchable overdrive stage. You can foot switch it or you can switch it on and off on the front. There's an effects loop, but there's no built-in reverb, so we're using a Source Audio Ventris, which we just happened to have lying around. Thanks, Source Audio. Great pedal, sounds fantastic, and it's just giving us a bit of splash on a plate setting with a medium to long decay. Now, let me talk you through some of the features on this amp, and then we'll try it out with some different guitars. I should note in the intro, by the way, you heard me playing this with my Paul Reed Smith McCarty soap bar, and we used a hand-built clone pedal both into the clean channel and into the overdrive stage, just so you can hear how it sounded. I was pretty impressed with the tone. I think it's absolutely wicked. So taking a look at the front panel, we have a deceptively simple control layout, starting with volume, which you may think of as a gain control for the clean channel, because it does start to break up as you dial it a little higher. We've got it set pretty conservatively right now. There's a bright switch, which I'll show you in a moment, and a three-band EQ, which is highly interactive with the overdrive stage because the tone stack is actually coming before the overdrive. So however you set this, that's gonna drive different frequencies into the overdrive circuit. Speaking of which, the overdrive circuit is over here. We have volume. Again, this is kind of another way of saying gain. Gain and volume are synonymous in the audio world. We just tend to think of them as separate things in the guitar world. Basically, it's how much signal you're driving into the clipping circuit. And then we have an output volume for the overdrive stage. And once again, you can switch that on and off with the included foot switch, or you can switch it on and off on the front panel. And then we have a master presence and a master output, along with a little fella down here to control whether the effects loop is hard bypassed or whether it's foot switchable. And a nice bright status LED over there to let you know the amp is on. So anyway, in the intro you heard me playing through this Paul Reed Smith McCarty soap bar with our clone. We're going to try the same with a Silver Sky because we just happen to have one here. Great guitar, I'm sure you'll agree. You can check out a review in a previous issue of Guitar Interactive magazine if you're so inclined. But for the time being, let's have a listen to how it sounds through the J-MOD. Thank you. Now, it should really come as no surprise that this guitar and this amp get on as well as they do, but of course that's going to be true for any single coil guitar. And the dynamic range and extended headroom in the J-MOD is just beautiful for that kind of clean single coil playing. And of course the overdrive stage, being as fat and thick sounding as it is wonderful with single coils, where the articulation and clarity that you get from these kinds of pickups really carries through into the overdrive voice. So let's explore the controls on the front panel a little deeper, and for this I'm going to record a loop on a Silver Sky and we'll hear how it sounds through various configurations on the front panel. Let's do that now. So as you can hear, the range of travel on all these controls is very broad and very musical. That's not to say that every sound we dialed in that previous example is necessarily the most musically pleasing, rather that there is a whole lot of range for you to tailor the amp to your particular guitar, your playing style, the cab that you're playing through, the situation that you find yourself playing in, whether it's stage or studio, and just your personal tonal preferences and playing style. Now, you would have noticed especially that there is lots of versatility with the overdrive circuit, and when we turn the volume control up, for example, and the volume control down on the gain stage, things respond very differently to when we flip that response. So this sounded a lot more furry on the top end and perhaps a bit more open in terms of dynamic response on the guitar, whereas this setup with those controls reversed was compressing the front end of the note a lot harder, but we're getting a cleaner and more chimey delivery with the overdrive circuit engaged. And then again, once we turn the overdrive up, you would have noticed that these tone controls become essentially a response shaping type circuit, where if we drive lots of treble into our overdrive sound, we get loads of chime and loads of clarity, whereas if we do the opposite, and we turn the bass and mid-range controls very high, especially with lots of overdrive, it's almost like a great germanium fuzz in that it's super fat and very harmonically dense. So really, you can conjure so many tones out of this amp, and of course it does clean up very, very nicely with your guitar's volume control And it takes pedals really nicely, as we found out in our intro jam. We're going to explore that a little more in depth now. And we have two pedals on the floor, which we're going to explore into the clean circuit and the overdrive circuit. We have a handmade clone, which we're going to set up as an overdrive and as a boost. And we also have an MI Audio crunch box, which you may recognize as the circuit that apparently inspired the Angry Charlie, which is a pretty ubiquitous overdrive pedal at this point in time. So we're going to try both of those, both clean and dirty. Let's start with the clone, and for this we're going to go back to our P90 guitar and we'll hear how that sounds. So I don't know about you, but I feel as though using the clone as an overdrive sounds absolutely fantastic into both the clean and overdriven settings on the J-MOD, and the rich harmonics in both the pedal and the amp get on absolutely beautifully. One thing that's quite interesting is the effect the bright switch has on the tone. It doesn't seem to have too profound of an effect on the clean sound of the J-MOD. However, as soon as you engage some overdrive, either from a pedal or with the amp's internal gain stage, it has a really large and pronounced effect on the way the top end responds. It's kind of a silky high end that's not as kind of like punchy in the 2K region as some bright switches can be. And it's certainly not harsh, but it is quite textured. So if you're more into rounded sounds, you can always knock that down and it's going to round out the treble response and perhaps any fizz that you might get from your pedal. But if you're more into kind of a brighter, more open delivery, switch the bright switch up and you'll get that in spades. Now, one thing I did notice as well is that setting the clone up as a boost with the gain control low and the volume control high did get a little bit muddy at times, but to be honest, one man's muddy is another man's fat. So you may find that that type of setting is just perfect for you. But personally, I prefer the conservative volume and quite a lot of gain on the pedal, which is actually quite unusual for boosting an amp in my experience. However, I'm going to attribute that down to the J-MOD's massive headroom and huge dynamic range. Anyway, let's move on to the crunch box. We're going to stick with our soap bars for now, and we'll hear how that sounds into the clean channel with the bright switch engaged and the bright switch disengaged, but we're not going to try it into the overdrive circuit because, to be honest, that's not really how you tend to run this kind of pedal. So let's hear how it sounds clean. So with this kind of pedal, the bright switch has a very profound effect, and that's true of any amp that you plug an amp in a box type pedal into. What is quite interesting though is while some bright caps when they're engaged can sound really harsh with a pedal like this, the J-MOD's bright cap just adds a crispy high end which may or may not be to your tastes. Personally, I preferred the bright switch disengaged for that more round vocal kind of tone, but if you like a little more crunch and hair on top of your amp in a box type pedal, you can engage the bright switch, safe in the knowledge that the results will be spectacular either way. So anyway guys, this has been the Paul Reed Smith J-MOD. They've re-released it for 2018. It's a wonderful sounding, surprisingly versatile single channel amp with loads of headroom. It's immensely punchy. The effects loop sounds great. The gain stage sounds great. It takes pedals wonderfully, gets on fantastically with P90s, with single coils, and as we're about to find out, with humbuckers. So I'm gonna play us out with some of those, but for the time being, my name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. This is the Paul Reed Smith J-MOD 2018, and I'll see you next time.